What's up guys, it is Kenneth91619 and today I'll be doing an unboxing, first look and a review for the Asus Maximus 6 Formula, and as Asus likes to call it, the unbeatable Z87 board with a double-sided ROG armor, and we'll get into that a bit later, but for now we're going to hop into what comes along with the motherboard, all the extra goodies and the manual. So starting off, when you open the box, you're going to be presented with a second box here. And inside, you have all the things you need to set up your motherboard, to hook it up to you. You know, your hard drives, your optical drives, and you got your I.O. shield panel there. And it comes with six SATA 6 cables. I.O. shield, get a bunch of labeling stickers, that's always good. Then you got your do not disturb the doorknob hanger, and enter champions on break, and of course with every motherboard or anything you practically buy in the market today, you got your manual or user's guide, and this helps people that are new to building computers, helps them out a bit. And this is an interesting thing here, this is the MPC combo 2, which is a 802.11 AC Bluetooth combo adapter. It's a Bluetooth 4.0. So basically you plug this into your motherboard and you can get Wi-Fi and Bluetooth out of this little module or a PCI, and it comes with a dual band 2.4 GHz or the 5 GHz channel, and it's got the latest technology in the 802.11 AC, like I mentioned, for the Bluetooth 4.0 module, and it's powered by Asus's exclusive Wi-Fi Go. So that's pretty badass, but you know, if you happen to buy your own Wi-Fi PCI Express card or whatever, or just a USB one, or just happen to run old school with an Ethernet cable, that's always an option. It does come with one SLI bridge, since this motherboard does support 8x8 SLI or a Crossfire 4x4x4 through your SLI. And then it also comes with the antenna for your Wi-Fi module. I like to call it module because that's cool. So that's cool. It's pretty plasticky, very lightweight. You're gonna have to tape this down to your desk, or possibly I would probably tape it behind your monitor. That'd be a good place to do it, or just the back of your case. And this motherboard's just loaded with a bunch of goodies. The reason I happen to buy this motherboard is because obviously the ROG armor, but also in a second I'll show you here, it comes with what they call cross chill, and basically what cross chill is, it's their hybrid thermal design. So it cools great on air, and 23 degrees Celsius cooler with water or any kind of pre-mixed water solutions out there on the market. And basically it's for your MOSFET, so you can lower down the temperature for that. It's got like these grills in there, and basically that's for your air cooling, and there's like these rubber plugs that I'm gonna take off in a second. You can take off, and it has two G1/4-inch threaded fittings, so you can put in your barb fittings, your compression fittings, or what the other ones are, what the fittings are called. But that's what that's for. So you can definitely water cool that if you want, and I happen to water cool mine. And Asus did mention that they have aluminum running in there, so it's definitely a good idea to have anti-corrosive additives in your distilled water or pure water, as some people like to say it. And another cool thing about this card is it comes with a 120 dB signal to noise ratio with integrated 600 OHM headphone amplifier built in directly to the motherboard. And this, you know, delivers premium sound, you know, sound card quality, so you don't have to go out there and buy, like, you know, an $80-$100 card sound card, because it comes with an equivalent already attached to the motherboard. That is a badass thing. As you already know, it's, you got the Extreme Digi Plus made with 10K black metallic capacitors that are made in Japan. That's the bet. That's, you know, top of line. You don't even have to guess it. Here's the what I mentioned before, the SLI. You got 2, 8, and the last one's a times 4 for a total of 2-way NVIDIA SLI or a 3-way crossfire. And the RG armor does not necessarily cool your motherboard. It's just more of a stylish thing, and it brings support to the motherboard, you know, just in case you get some flexing and whatnot when you put in your backplate for your CPU. This is a look at the backside. This thing is beast, guys. I would definitely recommend it. It's great for overclocking, and I hope you guys enjoy this video. Definitely subscribe and check out my other videos. Peace out, guys.